Hello friends, welcome you again. In this video, I'm going to discuss one topic from the environmental section, and the topic that I have taken over here is greenhouse effect, global warming and climate change. As you already having the idea, if you talk about the environmental and ecology portion, there are broadly four areas from where the questions are framed, and there is a whole domain of the environmental portion. Right? One is related to environmental pollution. Right? What are the sources of environmental pollutions and related? And the second one part is the related to the greenhouse gases and how those greenhouse gases are leading to global warming. Third is related to ozone depletion and ozone layer. Right? Ozone layer depletion basically. And the fourth portion is related to ecosystem and ecology. So these are the four broad areas from where question is framed. Right? So the first portion that I am discussing with you is related to your global warming, that is the greenhouse gases and how they are leading to the global warming, right? And then we will say about the climate change. So before moving on to see the term, discuss the global warming and climate change, first let us try to understand what is greenhouse effect and what is basically greenhouse. So once we are able to understand the meaning of greenhouse, then I think we can proceed to the next section. Now, if you break this term, let us say greenhouse, that means a house which will produce greenery, that way you can just think of. So it's a structure like the way you can see over here in the different photographs. Normally, these kind of houses or structures, they are made up of glass, right? So in most, many cases now, you are replacing this glass with some other kind of material also, like you're having plastic. From where, like, which is a little transparent and then rays can pass through it, right? So these structures which are basically, or these houses which are used to maintain the greenery inside them, we call them as a greenhouse, right? Now see, in what context we are making use of? Mostly you will find such kind of greenhouses in the hilly area or mountainous areas where, you know, the relative temperatures are quite low. And therefore, the existence of the plants and as well as you know, the population of the human beings is also and animals is also very thin. But for those for that particular population which is living over in those areas, and for them to survive, they have to obviously you are dependent on the plantations and all that. So in order to grow the plants and the vegetables, etc., so you make use of these houses. So normally what happens is because the temperature is very low, even in the daytime, nighttime, you can just think of in negatives. So in that case, for example, even if we do a certain kind of plantation, they will not be able to survive at such a lower temperature. So once you have constructed this, then in the daytime, whatever the energy that you get from the sun, that energy goes inside. Right? And once it goes inside, then that kind, that energy, that heat is trapped inside that particular structure. Right? Once it is trapped, then obviously in the at the night, as you can say, at night what happens is the cooling does not take place so easily because the heat has got trapped. It will cool, but that that cooling rate will be slow. Slowly that heat will dissipate. Had it been the case there was no such kind of structure, then Earth would have given up its heat at a faster rate and it would have gone down to a very low temperature. That is why that plants cannot grow. But now it is this house is able to maintain the warmer temperature inside this house, and that way the vegetation, plants and all those can grow inside it. So just you can just have a look. Agar aapne yahan par thoda sa with the help of the visuals, if you want to see, so you can just maintain the greenery, whether you grow vegetables, flowers, or maybe some other kinds of crops which are of significance to you. So for those purposes, you can make use of this greenhouse. Now just see these lines. Greenhouse is a house normally made up of glass, normally, but not always. As I said, you could use different other types of materials as well. Stays warmer inside even during the winters, right? Winters may be night time may relatively warm rahega, and therefore because heat is trapped by the glass, it's the same thing. Like if you are sitting inside your car and then obviously in the daytime that heat is coming inside from your windows and all that. So the inner portion of the car becomes, if you keep your windows closed, then it gets heated up too much, right? So in that case, what happens is, for example, whatever the heat that came that got trapped inside, and over, then that temperature, jo heat build up, uske karan temperature gets increases inside that particular car. The similar kind of analogy you can use over here also. Now let us talk about the greenhouse effect. That means how the temperature inside that particular greenhouse increases. Now since see this particular concept we are going to discuss in the context of Earth also. So therefore we first will discuss this in the context of a greenhouse, and then similar mechanism is going to be operable when we consider Earth as a whole. Okay, so just have a look. As you know, in case of, let's say this is a glass structure that you are having, greenhouse that you are having. So these are the solar radiations that you are getting from the sun. Now solar radiation, that means the energy that you are getting from the sun is in the different like wavelengths, right? So and predominantly, as you know, you are having like light that is coming in the different this is the electromagnetic spectrum of light that you already know, right? That means it falls like the most common form that you see is in the visible form. So visible light that you see, so it falls under a certain wavelengths ke vich ye fall karti hai. And as you move towards the infrared, microwaves and radio waves, they are fall under the category of long wavelength. That means wavelength goes on increasing as you are moving towards this. And as you are moving towards this end, that is the gamma rays, x-rays and ultraviolets, rays, they are the shorter wavelength rays, right? And as you know, these waves which are having shorter wavelengths, basically they carry larger amount of energy compared to the longer wavelength, those waves, right? So these are electromagnetic spectrum. Now the sun releases most of its energy, right? Sun se aapki jo energy aa rahi hai wo ek particular wavelengths mein aa rahi hai, most of the earth. Okay, significant portion jo ho sakta hai, that may fall on all the ends, but small portion of that means of those light, that particular energy that may fall on these ends, but significant portion of those, that solar energy falls under these three categories. Visible, as you know, we are able to see all these, and infrared portion and ultraviolet portion, which is our visual, beyond visual range, right? So significant portion of the almost all the, or you can say significant portion of the light that we receive from the sun is within this particular band of ultraviolet, visible and infrared rays. And if you make the comparison between these three, then out of this also maximum portion that you are going to get will be fall under the category of this infrared rays, right? Just have a look. You don't need to remember this picture and all that, but to give you an idea, roughly you can just see roughly 50% for infrared and near infrared. So total, that means roughly about 50%, that even 48% of the energy that is coming from the sun and the earth that is receiving, is about 48% is from in the infrared region. And then at the second position, what is almost 44% of the energy that you are receiving from the sun is in the visible range that you see, and a very small portion, roughly about 7%, is in the form of ultraviolet region. So ye aapko thoda sa idea hona chahiye ki from on what wavelengths basically most of the energy we are receiving from the sun, and why it is important you will see over here. Now see, as I said ki most of the energy that we are receiving is in these regions. At the same time, see, one more thing that you need to do, remember that when the temperature of the body is high, right, and you already know all those bodies which are having the temperature above 0 Kelvin, so they emit the radiations, right? So if the temperature of the body is very high, so that body is going to release most of the radiations that do that particular body is going to release, they will be shorter wavelength radiations, right? And cooler the body, then obviously longer wavelength radiations will be released, right? So if you want to have that information also, you can think of this over here, radiations of the sun and the earth. So since sun is a very heated body, so you can just think of shorter wavelength radiations will be produced by this body, whereas because relatively when we talk about the earth, its temperature is quite low, surface temperature is quite low, so radiation that is that are going to be released will be of what, longer wavelength or indirectly lower frequency or less energy, whereas in this case that means higher frequency and shorter wavelengths. That way you can see. Now if such is the case, then this is the situation. For example, here you are having a energy that is coming in the form of light, that is almost all these maximum is in the form of short wave radiations. So as it goes inside, because it carries significant, if it is a short wave, then short wave radiations can are in position to penetrate that particular this structure, or you can say if it's a glass that you're using, they can easily pass through that particular glass. Now see, so you're having ultraviolet, you're having infrared, you're having visible light. So all those wavelengths of these radiations, of particularly of high short wavelength, they are going to pass through it easily. And so that is why we have not shown here the ultraviolet rays, because the ultraviolet proportion is relatively very small, so not shown. But anyway, here if you were just see, this is a visible light which can penetrate easily, and the second one is infrared radiations of shorter wavelength, and mostly they will be the shorter wavelength radiations. And if there is a very small portion of those infrared radiations of longer wavelength, since they will carry smaller energy, they will be reflected back by the surface of this glass. Now once they go inside, then this visible light can easily reflect back, and also this visible light will heat up the surface of the earth which is inside this particular greenhouse. Same way, short wave infrared light also goes inside, and this will heat this surface which is inside that particular greenhouse. Now once it will get heated up, if I ask you what kind of radiations it will emit, earth surface, I am talking about the earth surface, then obviously earth surface is going to emit long wave radiations, and as you know, long wave radiations carry less energy, and more so the larger proportion of the radiations that will be re-emitted by the heated earth surface will be the infrared radiations. So now what is the situation? We are saying that this inner surface will get heated up, and its temperature is relatively low, even though it is heated up, but overall temperature when we compare with respect to sun, so it's very low. And once it gets heated up, then it will radiate its energy, and that energy mostly that will be in the form of infrared radiations, and those infrared radiations are of longer wave, long wave infrared radiations, right? So it means this long wave, you can just say red one is a long wave. This long wave infrared radiation which were coming from the sun were blocked by this, didn't allow, this glass didn't allow them to come inside. Same situation is going to happen for this also. The difference is that these long waves, very small proportion of the long wave radiations were emitted by the sun. Here these long wave radiations, infrared radiations, are emitted by the earth, but since they carry smaller energy, same light got reflected back. As this long wave radiation will strike this particular glass, then obviously they will be reflected back. And when they are reflected, then again they will remain inside, then again here they will be reflected, and again. So this process continues. That means this portion of the energy in the form of long wave infrared radiations will get trapped inside, cannot escape outside this particular glass house, which we call it as a greenhouse, and therefore overall temperature of this will remain high. So this is how basically is the mechanism of what? This is how basically this greenhouse keep the overall temperature inside it higher, and this phenomena is called as greenhouse effect. That means increase in the overall temperature of the inside of that house is called as greenhouse effect, and why that took place I explained you in detail. Now the same thing has been mentioned over here, just I am summing it up to you. The sun emits short wave radiations because it is extremely hot and a lot of energy gives off, right? And solar energy enters our atmosphere as a short wave radiation in the form of it. So these are the three significant: UV, infrared, and visible light. And infrared radiation is the electromagnetic radiations with longer wavelengths than those of the visible light. Okay, so that I think we have already seen. Infrared radiations, visible light se uski wavelength jyada hai, whereas that of ultraviolet, uski wavelength kya hai? Small hai. And therefore, generally invisible to the human. This is simply information. Earth is much cooler, but it still emit radiations, right? As I told you, which is having a temperature of higher than like 0 Kelvin is going to emit radiations, and earth emits long wave. So ye point aapke liye important hai, earth kya hai, this is going to emit the long wave radiations, and more or so mostly it is going to infrared radiations, because earth is cooler than the sun and has less energy available to give off, right? And the whole process I explained you, and this is, so ye jo process hai isko humne naam de diya greenhouse effect. So ye to this all this that we discussed are is related to what? when we took a greenhouse and we saw that how the temperature inside that particular greenhouse increased, and we give it a name called as greenhouse effect. Now, why we are studying this over here? Because the Earth atmosphere also behave in the similar way, right? जो Earth का atmosphere है, वो भी क्या करता है? That acts as a greenhouse and therefore increase the overall temperature of the Earth surface. And how it happens? Let's discuss now, right? Earth atmosphere does the same thing as the greenhouse. Earth किसका atmosphere? As you know, Earth is having its own atmosphere and it is having a different kinds of gases. And let's see the composition. You already know Earth is surrounded by its atmosphere containing different kinds of gases. And this is a basic factual information that you already have. What? Nitrogen, roughly 78% by volume, or oxygen, 21.21%. And then at third place, you are having argon, right? 0.9%. And the remainder, other gases also, many gases, but their proportion is very low. Just think of, just see over here, only remaining gases, these gases combined together, carbon dioxide, ozone, hydrogen, neon, helium and all that, even nitrous oxide, all these combined together constitute 0.1% of the total gases that you are having in your environment. तो ये तो आपको फैक्चुअल इन्फॉर्मेशन पता ही होनी चाहिए कि नाइट्रोजन सबसे ज्यादा है, देन ऑक्सीजन है, देन थर्ड प्लेस पे आर्गन, एंड देन यू हैविंग अदर गैसेस. दिस इन अदर गैसेस आल्सो यू आर गोइंग टू हैव द कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एट द फोर्थ प्लेस. आई थिंक दिस 0.0006% समथिंग दैट वे. सो दिस इज द सिचुएशन. नाउ हाउ दीज गैसेज आर इंपॉर्टेंट इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ ग्रीन हाउस इफेक्ट. द गैसेज इन द एटमोस्फेयर सच एज कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड डू वट द रूफ ऑफ द ग्रीन हाउस डज, right? Such as not only carbon dioxide but other gases also that I will discuss, that the way that glass behaved for the long wave radiations and therefore trapped those long wave radiations, these gases are also going to behave in the similar way. They will allow the shorter wavelength radiations to come inside, but when that long wave radiation, infrared radiations are emitted by the what, this particular Earth, they will be blocked by the these gases, and therefore if they are blocked, the overall temperature will increase. Then we will say that this, there will be a greenhouse effect on the Earth surface also. Clear? Okay, now let us see which one of these gases behave as a greenhouse gases. See, all the gases don't behave like the roof of that particular greenhouse, right? Only some of these gases behave, and which one of those gases are, let us discuss those. Now see, पहले हम बात कर लेते हैं अबाउट द गैसेज विच आर इन लार्जेस्ट प्रोपोर्शन, नाइट्रोजन एंड ऑक्सीजन. फॉर्चुनेटली फॉर यू, दीज गैसेज आर नॉट ग्रीन हाउस गैसेज. दैट मीन्स इवन इफ दे अलाउ दोज गैसेज, दैट पर्टिकुलर शॉर्ट वेव रेडिएशन टू कम इन साइड द अर्थ, टू फॉल ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द अर्थ, दे ऑल्सो अलाउ देम टू गो बैक. दैट मीन्स द लॉन्ग वेव रेडिएशन कैन एस्केप बैक टू दैट पर्टिकुलर स्पेस. सो दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू ब्लॉक. सो दैट इज गुड पार्ट. That means the largest proportion of the atmospheric gases are not blocking those radiation. Otherwise, the situation would have been different. I and you would not have existed over here. Okay. Now, the two main natural gases responsible for the greenhouse effect. अब बात करते हैं उन गैसेस की which are responsible for the greenhouse gas. Greenhouse effect. That is, one is water vapor as well as carbon dioxide. And as you know, water cycle you may be knowing. So water vapor are present and they behave as that particular greenhouse gases as well as carbon dioxide. Now, the gases which will act as the greenhouse gases other than these are, see, ek to aapka carbon dioxide, main I am going to talk major gases which will be acting as a greenhouse gases. One is carbon dioxide, ozone. Ozone, even though we will be discussing in ozone layer, even though more significant proportion of the ozone will be on the that is a stratosphere as a ozone layer, but despite that, some portion, if let us say if it is on the surface of the earth, it will be going to act as a greenhouse gas. Then you are having this one more is methane, potent gas. Then you are having one more nitrous oxide. So ye char gases to aapko tips pe honi chahiye. They are quite significant gases in terms of the producing the greenhouse gas. These three gases, if you see, I mentioned over, nitrogen, oxygen and argon are not greenhouse gases, or that is a good thing. So they are not greenhouse gases. They will not trap the heat. These gases, which are of relatively very low volume in the atmosphere, they behave as a greenhouse gases, trap the temperature. Trap that heat inside the Earth's atmosphere, and therefore maintain the temperature of the Earth as warm. Right? Now, iska aapko fayda bhi hai, nuksan bhi hai. Right? If I ask you that do you need to have some kind of warmer warmth on the surface of the Earth? Obviously, we will say definitely it is required. Because if you want to exist on this Earth, or whether plant life or animal life and all those, if you want to exist, then definitely you need to have a relatively warmer atmosphere, right? So if these gases were not present, see here, this side of left side of this particular photograph, natural greenhouse gas, greenhouse effect. Naturally means when human beings have not done something or released in larger proportion, then naturally whatever that has existed from so many years, if we take that situation, then we call it as a natural greenhouse effect. That means the effect due to the these gases, natural proportion of these gases which are producing the warmth on the surface of the Earth, we call it as natural greenhouse effect. Now see the situation. These are the solar radiation that are coming to the surface of the Earth. Some of this will be reflected as well, right? But let us say this is the proportion that is reaching the Earth's surface. Now Earth will get heated up, and a significant proportion of that will be re-radiated back. But naturally, since you are having methane, nitrous oxide, carbon dioxide, and like ozone, etc., as a greenhouse gases, so they only reflect back a smaller proportion of that particular energy. And larger amount of that proportion of that energy will be given up to the space. And therefore, since you are having a smaller proportion of the energy which is coming back to you, and therefore, naturally, ek overall jo warmth that will be maintained on the Earth's atmosphere, and which will be required for our existence. So if I ask you a question, do you need to have a natural greenhouse effect? Do you want that or not? Then obviously you will say definitely. If that will not happen, then we cannot survive on the surface of the Earth. Right? Now, let's see the situation now. Human enhanced greenhouse effect. See the meaning of this. Enhanced, increased. Human enhanced, that means human beings through their different activities, what they have done is they have released certain kind of gases on the atmosphere, which are more of like a greenhouse gases. And therefore, what has happened is overall jo greenhouse ki quantity, greenhouse gases ki quantity has increased, and therefore overall temperature has been increasing over a period of time. Right? So this is a natural situation. Now see this situation. Now what is happening is, this is the radiation. These are the radiation that you are receiving from the sun. Now, obviously the same proportion is getting re-radiated back after heating up of the Earth. But now what happened is, see these two arrows. Here this arrow was bigger. Here this arrow is bigger. Now what has happened is, you have released additional quantity of methane artificially. You have released nitrous oxide artificially. You have released carbon dioxide additionally into the atmosphere through your different activities. So what is happening is, since overall these greenhouse gases quantity has increased by your activities, and therefore what will now happen is larger proportion of this energy will come back. And therefore, and smaller proportion of energy will go into the space. And if larger proportion of energy is retaining, you are retaining back on the atmosphere, then you see this larger proportion is shown like kind of red, this color. That means overall temperature is increasing, right? So we can say this greenhouse effect is enhanced greenhouse effect, because overall temperature you are increasing by your these different activities. Now see these these lines over here. Greenhouse effect is a natural process. Obviously it has existed before you started doing some wrong activities, right? That warms the Earth's surface, and it is required. So this is we want. The main greenhouse gases include kaun si hai? Major kaun si hai? Water vapor, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, मिथेन, नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड, ओजोन। सो पहली बात तो यह है कि ये दीज आर द मेजर ग्रीन हाउस गैसेस, सम ऑफ द मेजर ग्रीन हाउस गैसेस दैट वी स्टडी, दैट वर प्रेजेंट व्हाट दे वर प्रेजेंट नेचुरली ऑल्सो, राइट। बट some of these naturally present gases, their release we have increased. For example, I will discuss with you carbon dioxide release we have increased, methane increase we have increased, nitrous oxide increase release we have increased, and even ozone is getting produced more and more now on the surface of the earth because of pollution and all that. So these are the, so they were present also and we are also increasing. In addition, some of the gases which are greenhouse gases, which has potential to increase the greenhouse effect, they have been totally made by human beings artificially. They were not present in the atmosphere previous to that. So that means these are some of the gases which are mentioned over here. For example, these are chlorofluorocarbons. Then you are having hydrochlorofluorocarbons and hydrofluorocarbons, etc. Now these are basically the refrigerants. You are having refrigerants, refrigerator, you are having ACs and cooling towers and all that, that kind of thing. So these, that means AC and related, refrigeration related activity, there you make use of these gases as a refrigerant. And when these gases get leaked or they go into the atmosphere, they behave as a greenhouse gases. So in addition to these, which were present in the atmosphere and they additionally increase their quantity into the atmosphere, we also produce some more compounds which are behaving as a greenhouse gases, and these are the artificial compounds that we produce. So you should be very clear from exam point of view. First, you should be very clear that these are the greenhouse gases, right? These are natural as well as we have increased their production also released into the atmosphere, and these are artificial, right? So, and one more is thing mentioned over here. This is not clear, but methane is much more potent. See, we are having, I mentioned that methane is also, carbon dioxide is also. So, but out of these two, if I ask you that which one is more dangerous in terms of like having impact of a greenhouse impact, you will say methane is more potent. Methane is more potent, meaning is that if you say take the same quantity of carbon dioxide as well as this methane, then methane is going to block larger proportion of those particular re-radiated infrared radiations, and therefore will be contributing more towards the increase in temperature. So that is why we will say more potent. It has more potential, higher potential to produce the greenhouse effect, to make that particular surface warmer compared to the carbon dioxide. But when we talk, most of the time we talk about the carbon dioxide. Why? Because carbon dioxide in quantity terms, we are releasing in a very large quantity when we compare with the methane. And that is why if you say which one of these, even artificial, which one of these are producing larger greenhouse effect, then you are going to say it will be the carbon dioxide. Why? Because the quantity of carbon dioxide that you have released into the atmosphere is too large compared to methane. Right? Okay. Let's now move further. Now we are going to see that in brief, I am going to discuss with you that these are the greenhouse gases and what are their sources, kahan se ye aa rahi and all that, so that you will be able to retain this information very simply and easily. Now see, anthropogenic water emissions are negligible. What we are saying is anthropogenic, that means by human related. So we by ourselves are not releasing water vapor into the atmosphere, even though we know that water vapor is a greenhouse gas, but through our activities, we have not been able to do much in terms of releasing that into the atmosphere, right? So whatever the natural cycle of water cycle that is maintained, more or less that is maintained, that has not got disturbed in terms of like release of water vapor into the atmosphere. So iska impact more or less utna hi tha, whatever it was originally as a natural. Now let's talk about the carbon dioxide. If I ask you that carbon dioxide release we have increased and it is a greenhouse gas. So if we have increased the release of carbon dioxide, what are those activities? Kahan se aa rahi hai carbon dioxide maximum? So these are mostly by burning of the fossil fuels, right? Fossil fuels kya hai aapke? For example, you are having this coal, you are having oil, that means petrol, diesel and all those, kerosene oil and all that, and natural gas, etc. So these all basically jo fossil fuel hai, we are burning lot of fossil fuel for our developmental activities, right? For example, our dependence on the energy, हमें basically क्या है, टू मेंटेन अवर लिविंग स्टैंडर्ड एंड ऑल दोस जिसके ऊपर हमारी डिपेंडेंस है, वेदर वी टॉक अबाउट द व्हीकल्स, वेदर वी टॉक अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, अगर वो हमें चाहिए तो द एनर्जी दैट वी नीड फॉर दोस एक्टिविटीज कहां से आएगी? दैट विल मोस्टली एज ऑफ नाउ इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द बर्निंग ऑफ द फॉसिल फ्यूल. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इलेक्ट्रिसिटी जनरेट करना चाहते हो, सो मोस्टली आर डिपेंडेंस इज कोल बेस्ड थर्मो पावर स्टेशन और मे बी लाइक गैस बेस्ड थर्मो पावर स्टेशन. ऑल आर रिलीजिंग ए ह्यूज अमाउंट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इन टू द एटमोसफियर एंड दैट इज द सिचुएशन ऑल अक्रॉस द ग्लोब. सेम इज यू आर हैविंग पेट्रोल डीजल, यू आर बर्निंग दैट in your vehicles and therefore they are releasing the carbon dioxide. So in totality, if you want to say fossil fuel, coal, oil, natural gas, they produce the largest part of the carbon dioxide release into the atmosphere. Let's talk about the methane. Methane ke bahut sare sources hain. Some of these sources are basically more or less they are artificially in nature, more or less. Kuch ek hum natural we will see, I will discuss with you. The more or less they are like artificial in nature. Now fossil fuel methane kahan se aayegi? Natural gas hai, we call it as a natural gas or methane, CH4 as you know. And so this is produced again. Kahan se aayegi? This comes from fossil fuel, right? So fossil fuel again. आपने देखा होगा कि वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द गैस, लिक्विफाइड नेचुरल गैस, और मोस्टली व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट वेयर वी गेट, वेयर आर दोज पर्टिकुलर सोर्सेज ऑफ दैट. इन मोस्ट ऑफ द लोकेशंस वेयर यू गोइंग टू फाइंड द ऑयल फील्ड्स, जहां से आप ऑयल एक्सट्रैक्ट करते हो, लाइक क्रूड ऑयल फ्रॉम वेयर यू मेक, फ्रॉम विच यू मेक पेट्रोल डीजल एक्सेट्रा, फ्रॉम देयर इन दो अराउंड दोज लोकेशन एंड इन वेयर इवन इन दोज वेल्स on top of those wells you are going to find those natural gas, right? So it is a fossil in origin, and that is why if you will see that the fossil fuel production basically are going to release off these a lot of these gases, this methane particularly. Production distribution use, production jahan se nikali wahan se some of the gas will be released in the atmosphere. I don't know whether you have seen somewhere where oil drilling takes place and sometimes event is given up and from there continuously that fire is coming, like blowing out, right? Because the burning is taking place because that natural gas is coming out and you have lit it up, right? So that is why that you can see that fire. So jahan par aap produce kar rahe hain, there distributing when you are taking from one place to another, because leakage may take place, and use jahan use kare wahan bhi leakage ho sakti hai. So all these activities are related into the production of methane. Livestock farming ka matlab hua ki aapka jo cattle hain, for example कैटल्स हैं बेसिकली. सो कैटल के जो स्टमक में है डाइजेशन, ड्यूरिंग द डाइजेशन प्रोसेस लॉट ऑफ मिथेन इज प्रोड्यूस्ड एंड व्हेन वे दे विल एक्सहेल देन ऑब्वियसली आउट ऑफ दैट बर्पिंग, वी कॉल इट एज बर्पिंग, दैट इज थ्रू द माउथ दैट कम्स आउट, राइट? एंड सो मिथेन एक सोर्स है. अब एज यू नो लाइफ स्टॉक फार्मिंग का मतलब ये हुआ कि वी आर एज यू नो आर डिपेंडेंस ऑन मीट इज टू ह्यूज एंड देयरफॉर वी आर लाइक रीयरिंग लॉट ऑफ दोज एनिमल्स, these livestock, and therefore when we are rearing for our consumption purpose, then obviously kya hoga, when larger is the population of the cattle, then obviously you are going to have the large amount of will be released by all them. Landfill and waste, jahan par waste hai aapka, jo waste hai when it gets decomposed, then there also carbon dioxide is released. Larger the waste, larger not carbon dioxide, this methane is also released. So landfills ho gaye, unko bhara aapne. Landfills ka matlab where you dump that waste, right? उस एरिया को लैंडफिल बोल देते हैं. देयर आल्सो बायोमास बर्निंग एंड बायोफ्यूल. बायोमास बर्निंग ऑफ फॉर एग्जांपल लकड़ी है, लकड़ी लाइक दैट बर्निंग ऑफ वुड, दैट इज बायोमास, दैट वुड इज बायोमास, राइट? सो बर्निंग, उसकी बर्निंग में भी आपका मिथेन निकलेगी एंड देन बायोफ्यूल्स जो है फॉर एग्जांपल इथेनॉल एंड ऑल दोस दैट आप यू आर हैविंग मेनी फ्यूल्स दैट राइट नाउ यू आर प्रोड्यूसिंग बाय मेकिंग यूज ऑफ दोस बायोलॉजिकल, जैसे शुगर केन हो गया एंड सम काइंड ऑफ लाइक क्रॉप्स, उनका यूज करके आप जो है यू आर प्रोड्यूसिंग दोस पर्टिकुलर फ्यूल्स. एंड सो इन दैट प्रोसेस बिकॉज है तो बायोलॉजिकल ऑरिजिन का ही है, सो यू आर गोइंग टू हैव दैट काइंड ऑफ मिथेन. सो यू शुड नो दैट दीज आर सम ऑफ द एरियाज फ्रॉम वेयर मिथेन इज प्रोड्यूस्ड, पर्टिकुलरली मोर ऑफ लो बिकॉज ऑल दीज एक्टिविटीज मोर ऑर लेस आर रिलेटेड टू आर्टिफिशियली वी हैव इंक्रीज एंड देयरफॉर ये आर्टिफिशियल नेचर की है. एंड इसको मैं बाद में डिस्कस करता हूं आपसे. एक लेट मी जस्ट गिव एन एग्जांपल नेचुरल ऑल्सो मिथेन इमिशंस का. सो नेचुरली मिथेन जो है बेसिकली comes out from these areas, wetlands. Wetlands basically क्या है? Those lands जहां पर आपको ज्यादातर पानी मिलेगा, right? Water is spreading all across and waterlogged भी बोलते हैं हम उनको areas को, right? जैसे सुंदरबन area है आपका in West Bengal, तो waterlogged जो वहां पर soil मिलेगी आपको, that soil which is having larger proportion of water in spreading all across, right? So usko we call it as a wetland area. So there also you basically you find the different kinds of microbes over there which are acting in those areas, wet areas, which basically release a lot of methane into the atmosphere, and that is basically natural process. That is not like you are, you can enhance that process by like carrying out agriculture practices. Like if you have increased the agriculture activity to a larger extent, then obviously it is going to influence. So termites, okay, you are going to have termites matlab kide mukode, which we call again same kind of, they are going to have some kind of microbes in their guts and which are producing methane. Then oceans also, methane producing microbes living in the oceans, microbes, some kind of microorganism they are living, so through their ingestion activity they release the those methane into the atmosphere. So these are some of the natural sources, so you should be very clear about kahan produce hoti hai wetlands. If you give the example, natural sources of, as of now naturally jo hai wo sabse zyada largest proportion of methane comes from where, this could be the question for you, right? So aise frame kiya ja sakta. So you should be very clear that almost larger proportion of the methane naturally that is getting produced comes out from this particular agriculture, this particular wetland areas, right? As I mentioned you, wetland areas wahan se naturally aayega, right? So I hope you, what I discussed with you till now is this, that carbon dioxide kahan se sources kya hai, methane ke sources kya hai, you need to have idea, little idea, and relative importance pata honi chahiye. Now let's see how they are contributing towards the different gases contributing towards the greenhouse effect, right? Greenhouse effect matlab in the generation of the warmth on the surface of the earth, what is the relative contribution of these different gases. If it considered naturally, agar hum naturally baat kare, that we, let's say if we ignore that humans have not like released any additional proportion of these greenhouse gases in the environment, then which one will be contributing more? So largest proportion will be water vapor and clouds, which frequently gets formed, right? So sabse zyada jo hai wo kya karenge, they are going to block these particular radiations, right? That you can realize even, agar aapko ek bahut hi simple example lena hai, agar this din for example day time mein you are having a, let us say it was sunny day, and in the night time let us say if you know, in normal days when there are no clouds, then it will cool faster, right? But if that day in the evening you are having clouds, then overall temperature of the evening will be higher. Why? Because the radiations, re-radiated radiation, emitted radiation by earth, which had to go back to the space, now have been blocked by the clouds and all that. So that way overall temperature kya hota hai, us temporarily jo hai that got increased. But overall hum baat kare to, that is going to, water vapor and clouds are going to have the largest, and then second number pe you are going to have the carbon dioxide is having the larger proportion, greenhouse effect, because proportion is relatively larger than others, and then methane. So ye aapko pata hona chahiye, at least you should know 2-3 these in sequence. The largest naturally sabse zyada influence water vapor, and then at second number it is carbon dioxide. When we talk naturally is important, natural greenhouse effect, right? So approximate greenhouse effect when we are talking naturally only. Now let us say if you consider that how the situation would be, let us say if you consider only the artificial artificially, that let us say if I am releasing as a human beings, we are releasing different greenhouse gases in the environment. So let us say if I have released certain gases in the environment, which one of these gases are producing the largest amount of that particular greenhouse effect, right? So that situation is over here. Approximate contribution of the greenhouse effect, if we consider anthropogenic factors only. Anthropogenic means if you consider the influence of human activities, that let us say only human activities naturally, if we ignore the natural, and because of human activities only, whatever the gases that have been released, out of those gases, released gases, which gas is contributing largest to the greenhouse effect? That answer I have already given you, that is you are already having carbon dioxide artificially, because we have released a larger, very large proportion of the carbon dioxide into the environment, and then at second stage is methane. So methane, even though we are releasing at a relatively very less quantity compared to carbon dioxide, but methane's potential to produce the carbon, this greenhouse effect is too large, and therefore at second place you are going to have this one. And then I think third and fourth place you don't need to remember, more or less these variations can take place like 10 12 or 8 9 10, something that way. So relatively idea you need to have which one is the largest and followed by which one, when we talk simply in terms of artificial effect. right? So these are the things you need to know. Keep in mind, data is not important, but relative contribution is more important. So what we discussed? We discussed till now about the carbon dioxide, then we discussed about the methane, water vapor ke bare mein humne baat kar li. Let us talk about the some of the other greenhouse gases or the elements which are producing or compounds which are producing greenhouse gas. I told you about the halocarbons, right? And then nitrous oxide also we will discuss, because they through human activities we are releasing these gases also in significant amount, and that is why we need to discuss about them. So first, halocarbons. Even though I have already given you the example of like refrigerant, mostly jo halocarbons hain, halogen group ka, as you already know, knowing like fluorine, bromine and all those, us group se item hai. Halo compounds are chemicals in which or more and more carbon atoms are linked by covalent bond and all that. This is a chemical definition, you already know. One or more halogen atoms like chlorine, fluorine and iodine, to is group ke jitne bhi aapke hain unko halocarbons bolte hain, right? Kahan par use hai, hamare liye important hai ki where basically these compounds are being used mostly, and because of those applications, because they are being used over there, they are getting released into the atmosphere and therefore are producing greenhouse effect. Now see, used as refrigerants, ye to maine example already de diya tha. For example, chlorofluorocarbons, hydrochlorofluorocarbons, they fall in this category. See, chlorofluorocarbons we will see in case of ozone depletion, because they are all, see, one more thing that we have to keep in mind, chlorofluorocarbons we will discuss in ozone layer also. Chlorofluorocarbons, where they are ozone depleting substances also. Okay, your refrigerants say hydrochlorofluorocarbons, chlorofluorocarbons, they are ozone ko deplete karne wale substances bhi hain. They are ozone depleting substances also. They are substances which produce greenhouse effect. Do teen cheeze confuse nahi hona hai aapne. If I ask you, ozone is a greenhouse gas or not? Yes, it's a greenhouse gas. If I say some of the elements which destroy the ozone, are they greenhouse gases or not? Definitely. Chlorofluorocarbons, they destroy the ozone layer. Ozone ko destroy karte hain ye. Hydrochlorofluorocarbon, they destroy the ozone. But also these, some of these ozone depleting substances are also greenhouse gases. Right? Ye point aapne dhyan rakhna hai. Isme confuse nahi hona hai. Okay, sorry. So now, so one is that these mostly they are being used as refrigerants and used as propellants in the sprays. जो spray की bottles आती हैं, cans देखी होंगी आपने, foam है. For example, आप perfume use करते हो, तो perfume में क्या होता है कि when you press that knob, then spray की form में जो है आपका perfume basically आता है, right? So with that particular liquid perfume, you have mixed some other elements or chemicals. They are basically halocarbons के कुछ compounds हैं, उनको हम बोलते हैं propellants. उनका काम क्या है, आप क्या करो, propellants को mix करोगे with perfume, right? So that क्या होगा कि जैसे ही वो आपका high pressure में, because they are stored in high pressure, when you press the knob, तो वो क्या करेंगे, propellants क्या करेंगे उसको, they will get converted into the gaseous form, right? This propellant will get converted into gaseous form, and therefore what will do, it will spray those these particles of those this particular perfume. That means perfume will be sprayed in a very fine particles form, right? So perfume particle form mein properly get sprayed over you. Uske liye hum use karte hain kuch ek elements jinko hum bolte hain propellants. Mainly they are from the halocarbon group se hi hain, right? And since they will, once they are released, they are what they are greenhouse gases, right? And then manufacturing of plastic forms and semiconductor. So ye kuch aur activities hai, wahan par bhi you are making use of some of these halocarbons, like semiconductor banane ke liye, plastic forms banane ke liye there. So these are some of the uses where you are making use of the halocarbons, and obviously they are getting released. Refrigerants hain, aapke ghar mein fridge hai to aap bolte ho na kabhi kharab ho jaye, kai baar aisa hota ki after let us say 3 4 5 years later bolte gas leak hogi. Gas kya leak hui, ye refrigerant aapka leakage hua. Once this refrigerant goes into the atmosphere, then what is this? Is a greenhouse gas. So think of like millions and millions of such refrigerator ACs and all those cooling devices, they are operating, and over a period of time that leakage may take place, and therefore they will be subjected to this greenhouse effect may be released. Then nitrous oxide, this is also one of the potential greenhouse gas, right? And relative potential we are going to discuss you, because there are many gases which are having a this the potential of causing a greenhouse effect is very high. So we will be discussing those through questions, I think. That will be a better way, where we will take the different possibilities that which one of these gases are having the highest this potential in terms of greenhouse effect. Now, when we talk in terms of the artificial release of nitrous oxide products, see, this gas is the byproduct of microbial activity. पहली बात तो यह है कि नाइट्रोजन साइकिल होता है, जैसे आप ऑक्सीजन साइकिल है, नाइट्रोजन साइकिल है, वाटर साइकिल है, सेम वे जो दिस साइकिल के थ्रू, नाइट्रोजन साइकिल के थ्रू दिस जो बैक्टीरियाज हैं, दे ऑपरेट ऑन द सरफेस ऑफ द अर्थ, दैट मींस ऑन द सॉइल, एंड देयरफॉर इन दैट प्रोसेस नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड इज रिलीज. तो वन इज योर नाइट्रोजन साइकिल के थ्रू, बैक्टीरियल एक्शन के थ्रू नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड इज रिलीज इनटू द एटमॉस्फेयर. नाइट्रोजन फिक्सेशन टेक्स होती है, आई डोंट नीड टू गो इन टू डिटेल, बट बेसिकली क्या है, फ्रॉम द एटमॉस्फेयर देर आर सम बैक्टीरिया विच फिक्स द नाइट्रोजन ऑन द रूट्स ऑफ दोज प्लांट्स. सो इन दैट प्रोसेस जो है वो नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड एंड ऑल दैट दैट इज ऑल्सो फॉर्म. सो वन सोर्स इज दिस यूज ऑफ फर्टिलाइजर, राइट. फर्टिलाइजर का काम भी क्या है, नाइट्रोजन, फॉस्फोरस, पोटेशियम एटसेट्रा, न्यूट्रिएंट्स प्रोवाइड करना. तो ऑब्वियसली दैट ड्यूरिंग दैट प्रोसेस ऑल्सो वेन यू यूज एज ए फर्टिलाइजर ऑन द सॉइल, तो वो नाइट्रोजन साइकिल विल बी इन्वॉल्व, सो दैट वे दे आर ऑल्सो नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड इज प्रोड्यूस. एंड सम केमिकल इंडस्ट्री नाइट्रिक एसिड HNO3, राइट, प्रोडक्शन एटसेट्रा, दे आर नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड इज रिलीज, राइट. सो this is these are some of the artificial activities you can say where nitrogen nitrous oxide is produced. Because why we are talking about nitrous oxide, even though this may be released in small quantity, but the in terms of greenhouse effect, it is a potential greenhouse gas. So that is why we need to discuss a little about it. So and if you want to see in terms of human sources from where it is the significant list, agar my simple question is, can be framed that which one of these areas largest amount of human activities, which one of the following human activities the largest amount of nitrous oxide is released, which is a greenhouse gas, you can say agriculture related activity largest proportion is released, right. So that is how you have to see. And then another one is the ozone also. Ozone, as I have already discussed with you, stratosphere mein, as you know, ozone jo hai, that UV radiations ko, it does not, that means almost all the ozone is you will find in the stratosphere region in the form of a ozone layer. Very insignificant proportion will be on the surface of the earth, that is earth ke atmosphere ke lower portion mein rahega, right. But because of like different activities, pollution and all those, we can generate that, matlab that gets generated on the surface of the earth. Otherwise, most of that particular ozone is going to be where in the stratosphere region, and it is naturally present. But as I have told you, this is the greenhouse gas. Let me sum up about the different gases which I discussed with you. You could have water vapor, you could have carbon dioxide, you have methane. I also discussed with you our natural as well as all those. Then you have nitrous oxide, you have halocarbons, hydrofluorocarbons, chlorofluorocarbons, and all those. And you are already having, I think, one more I discussed with the nitrous oxide, I discussed with you, then ozone at last. So these up, you need to know the that these are some of the greenhouse gases, and from there where they are released and relative potential kya hai. And I think I mentioned about the halocarbons, chlorofluorocarbons aapko mention kiya main. Aaj ki date mein we have replaced this, right. I will discuss with you in ozone layer also. Nowadays we don't have, we are not making use of chlorofluorocarbons. So iska danger to almost you can just think of as of now is not there, because since it was depleting the ozone, तो ओजोन को बचाने के लिए हमने इसको रिमूव करना शुरू कर दिया था. सो नाउ वी आर नॉट प्रोड्यूसिंग इट एंड ऑल दैट, देयर इज बैन ऑन दिस. सो क्लोरोफ्लोरोन एज ऑफ नाउ सिचुएशन, अगर पूछा जाए यू आर गोइंग टू टेल, बट एज ऑफ नाउ सिचुएशन बताओगे वी आर नॉट यूजिंग एज ऑफ नाउ, प्रोडक्शन हैज बीन रिड्यूस सबस्टेंशियली. नाउ यहां टर्म अपियर होता है एट द एंड, ग्लोबल वार्मिंग. वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट ग्रीन हाउस इफेक्ट, then we are talking about the global warming, right. So greenhouse humne discuss kar liya, greenhouse effect uske karan kya hua, overall increase in temperature, right. Then I say global warming has names to this. Global warming, that is warming of the globe, kiske karan, because of the greenhouse effect kyon aaya, because we are releasing greenhouse gases in the environment. What are the greenhouse gases? I have already discussed with you. What they are doing? They are blocking all those infrared radiation, particularly the long wave infrared radiations, because we have released those in large quantity, and therefore blockage of that heat, and therefore that means overall temperature is increasing. That's all. Those common names are global warming. Now let us say, or now this situation has become very alarming. I think in news also, in a regular basis, you keep on hearing that global warming, this may be the result of flooding, global warming, this may have been because of the global warming and all that, right. So now when the average overall temperature of the atmosphere, see, naturally jo aapko on an average atmospheric temperature that you were getting was comfortable for you to survive. And also weather phenomena, you are having like rainfall, snowfall, you are having all those other different weather phenomena that exist on the surface of the earth. They are solely dependent upon the amount of heat that you are getting from the sun, that amount of heat that you are retaining on the surface of the earth, and because of the temperature variations that are taking place because of that heat. So that this basically that is the basis for the whole all of the climatic change, sorry, the whole of that particular weather phenomena that is existing on the surface of the earth. Now ab kya kar rahe ho aap, aapne uska heat jo budget hai aur kind of heat ka jo pattern hai, that you are now changing because of your different activities. So if that happens, the overall temperature will increase, then you can just think of what will happen. So usse related, what is the impact that you are going to have, what is the effect that you are going to have on the surface of the earth if on an average temperature jo hai wo kya ho increase hoga over a period of time. That has started already increasing, right? I will discuss with you on the next video where what are the international community, what steps international community is taking in order to control the climate change. Now what will happen is, climate kya hoga, global warming hui to overall climate kya ho jayega, change hoga, and that is taking place. So we need to discuss, after that I will discuss with you in detail that what steps as a human beings coming together, whole world coming together is taking in order to control this climate change. Climate change ka matlab ye hai, in order to reduce the increase in temperature. So increase in temperature, if you can reduce, then obviously you can prevent this global warming. If you can prevent the global warming, you can prevent the what, that particular that climate change that is taking place. Okay, so for example, we will discuss with you different kinds of like Kyoto Protocol, then I'm going to Paris Climate Deal, Kigali Agreement, and all those, that Brundtland Commission, and all those things will be detailed, and they are very directly related to your exam, right? Direct straightforward questions are asked from there. But before that, let us see what this increase in temperature, or you can say greenhouse effect, which is leading to global warming, will going to have. So these are the some of the effects that you can just imagine when you're going to have the global warming. Overall globe ka temperature, surface atmosphere temperature badh jayega, to obviously ice melting worldwide, especially at the earth's pole. As you know, earth's pole, that is if you go to the Antarctica, which is the ice cap fully, right? So think of, imagine polar areas may be ice melt hogi because temperature got increased in the low, that means upper north pole may be, or south pole Antarctica may, whole of the ice gets melted. If it melts, then what will happen? You can think of the overall sea level will increase. So sea level increase hoga, what is going to have? Coastal flooding. There are low lying areas which are near the coast, overall water level increase ho jayega, right? You are having so many islands, island nations. What will happen to them? They will submerge, right? So that is the danger that you are going to have. So that means, so one is that obviously ice melting worldwide, isi se related hai aapka, isse related hai, you are having the sea level has been rising more quickly over the last century. This we have observed slowly, this sea level is increasing. So this is a danger obviously to the island nations. So these two points are related. Many species have been impacted by the rising temperature. See, there are many species which are very sensitive to the temperatures, right? So if temperature changes will take place, obviously they will be in danger. Just think of, I heard, I think 15 years back, or maybe I don't exactly remember, I heard a news where over average temperature in the, that means summers in a European country, like I think in France, that went to 40 degree, right? And you know, these are the cooler climatic areas where temperature remains relatively low, and in summers are very pleasant. Think over there where you are having a 40 degree temperature. I think there were hundreds of deaths were reported over there. I don't know exactly know the number, but that means, see, if in one summer, if the temperature went to 40 degree in that particular area, human beings can die. In India, think of a situation, 40 is normal, average 45, 46 and all that. That means in some area, it may happen that over here, if the climatic change will take place, the temperature in India may go up. But think of those situations where already the temperature is low and people are adapted to that climate. Now, if they are subjected to sudden fluctuation in this temperature, then they will be in danger. And think of other species also, which will be having the similar kind of fate. Precipitation, rainfall, snowfall may increase across the globe on an average. See, टेम्परेचर, ओवरऑल टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज होगा तो ऑब्वियसली क्या है रेनफॉल पैटर्न, बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली द क्लाउड फॉर्मेशन टेक प्लेस फ्रॉम द इवेपोरेशन एंड देन रेनफॉल विल टेक प्लेस राइट. इन इंडिया ऑल्सो मॉनसून इज अबाउट टू कम राइट, एंड लार्जली डिपेंड्स अपॉन दैट हाउ मच द इंटीरियर ऑफ द इंडिया पर्टिकुलर नॉर्थ वेस्टर्न इंडिया राजस्थान एरिया पंजाब हरियाणा एंड ऑल दिस रीजन गेट्स हीटेड अप राइट. इफ इट्स गेट हीटेड अप देन ऑब्वियसली लो प्रेशर एरिया विल बी जनरेटेड एंड देयरफॉर इट विल ड्रॉ द विंड्स फ्रॉम द ओशन राइट. सो दैट मीन्स think of if temperature goes further up, rainfall may increase. So point is that weather pattern will completely get disturbed, right? So that means overall precipitation, because temperature will go increase and therefore on an average, jo hai, wo kya ho sakta. And also erratic, it is not that, okay, there will be kind of like, ho sakta hai, na, temperature if it increases over there in Europe, तो वेदर पैटर्न चेंज हो जाएगा पूरा. अभी उनके जो हो सकता है एक पर्टिकुलर सीजन हो जहां पर बारिश नहीं होती होगी समर्स में लट से, सो इफ टेम्परेचर गोज अप देन हो सकता है इट मे रेन एंड समथिंग दैट वे. सो दैट इज द डेंजर. अनदर डेंजर, फ्लड्स एंड ड्रॉट्स विल बिकम मोर कॉमन राइट. तो इन सम एरियाज ड्रॉट सूखा राइट, एंड इन सम एरियाज इट मे हैपन दैट लॉट ऑफ रेनफॉल विल टेक प्लेस एंड ऑब्वियसली व्हाट विल हैपन देन फ्लडिंग काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशन में एग्जिस्ट एंड देन यू आर हैविंग लेस फ्रेश वाटर. अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द फ्रेश वाटर ऑन द सर्फेस इज ऑफ द अर्थ इज ऑलरेडी वेरी लेस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लेक्स एंड ऑल दोज अंडरग्राउंड वाटर, बट वेन काइंड ऑफ लाइक दिस ग्लोबल वार्मिंग काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशन विल टेक प्लेस देन ऑब्वियसली फ्रेश वाटर शॉर्टेज मे बी ऑब्जर्व इन मेनी एरियाज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर किसी एरिया में जो आपका वॉट हैपन्स इफ temperature goes up, then obviously jo surface water resources and they will dry up, right? They are the sources for fresh water. Or it may happen that your dependence on the underground water will increase and you will start drawing more water, fresh water, and that will be consumed. And since you are having no water from outside, and it may happen that you will have a shortage of fresh water in many areas. So, but we cannot tell. If we are in position to tell, I think we may not have discussed that much, but we cannot tell where this situation is going to come if this global warming kind of situation is observed over a period of time, and if we don't stop these climate changes that are going to happen, right? So this is how the topic is. So this is the basic of this greenhouse effect, global warming and all that. This all I have already discussed. This is the heat budget, amount of heat that we are going to get. शुरू में मैंने बात की थी एनर्जी आपके सर कुछ एक सम ऑफ द एनर्जी इज गेट रिफ्लेक्टेड बैक बाय अर्थ आल्सो बाय द एटमॉस्फेयर आल्सो सम पोर्शन रिमेन्स एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द पोर्शन गोज अवे स्मॉलर पोर्शन गोज बैक इट इज गुड सो दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड बट नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस इफ लार्जर प्रोपोर्शन इज कमिंग बैक स्मॉलर पोर्शन गोइंग अवे we are going towards the global warming. So that is all in this chapter. So whatever I have discussed with you, if any question comes, you will be in position. That means you will be able to all answer all the questions if it is related to this particular topic. So the only point is that you understand it properly. And in the next video, as I told you, I'm going to discuss with you the international efforts that we are taking in order to control the climate change. Till then, bye. Thank you.